Hi everyone. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to clean install macOS Sequoia without a bootable USB installer. I will use the Erase All Content and Settings feature to reset my Mac to its factory settings without wiping and formatting my hard disk drive or SSD. In this tutorial, I will first upgrade from Sonoma to Sequoia on my MacBook Pro M1 and then reset it to factory settings. You may ask, do I have to perform a clean install? The answer is no. However, installing a new OS over an old one sets you up for problems in the future. Therefore, I recommend a clean installation to remove all the accumulated junk files, annoying quirks, and unneeded apps you may have installed on your Mac and forgotten to uninstall. Please keep in mind the following points before installing macOS Sequoia. Ensure that your Mac is compatible with macOS Sequoia. Backup all your important files to an external device. Keep your user account password, network password, and Apple ID handy. Before installing a new operating system, it's important to check your hard disk drive or SSD for any issues. To do this, type disk utility in the Spotlight search box and press Enter. Once you have selected your drive, click on the first aid icon and then click Run. If the operation is successful, click Done and close the window to exit the disk utility app. Ideally, perform a clean installation on your day off, ensuring you have enough time for troubleshooting and getting help if necessary. To perform a clean installation of macOS Sequoia and reset my MacBook Pro to its factory settings, I will first upgrade from my current OS Sonoma to Sequoia using software update. To do this, click on System Settings in the dock, then click General in the left sidebar, and select Software Update. If macOS Sequoia does not appear in the Software Update section, you can download it from the App Store by typing macOS Sequoia in the search box and clicking Get. The download time will vary depending on your internet speed. Once downloaded, it will be available in your applications folder and you can launch it from there. I will click Upgrade now, click Agree, enter my admin password, and click OK. In the second stage of the process, I will perform a clean installation to reset my Mac to its factory settings. This feature is useful if you plan to sell or give away your Mac. I will stop recording this video and resume when the download is complete.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
Upgrading from macOS Sonoma to Sequoia on my M1 MacBook Pro took 45 minutes. To avoid problems in the future, I will reset the macOS Sequoia to its factory settings. To reset it to factory settings, I will launch System Settings click General in the left sidebar, then Transfer or Reset. After that, I will click Erase all content and settings. In the next step, I'll enter my admin password in the Erase Assistant dialog prompt and click Unlock. By clicking Continue all settings, media and data for all volumes on this Mac will be erased, as well as the following items. After that, I'll enter the password for my Apple ID and click Continue. Then click Continue again. Finally, click Erase all content and settings. This is the final step and cannot be undone. After resetting your Mac to factory settings, you will need to spend some time setting it up. If you are new to using a Mac or need help setting up your new operating system, watch this step-by-step tutorial. I will leave the link to the tutorial in the description box below this video. As I mentioned, perform a clean installation on your day off or on the weekend when you have plenty of time. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.